Good day, everyone! I am here to present our video lecture in basic calculus. The topic to be discussed is all about continuity of a function at a number. When we say continuity of a function at a number, what comes into your mind? When you say that the function has to be in a continuous state, then you're right. The real definition of this topic is if C is a number in an interval a, b, and f is a function with a domain containing the interval a and b, then f is said to be continuous at x equals to c. Quite difficult, right? There are three conditions that we need to consider. First, f of c is defined. Second, the limit of f of x as x approaches to c exists. And lastly, limit of f of x as x approaches to z is equal to f of c. This is an example of a graph that illustrates a continuous function. It shows that the given function has no gap and spaces between the lines. Now, with this condition, we can say few different things, or at least be able to test as if the function is continuous at a point or not. On the other hand, we should actually check these three things. Step 1, f of c is defined. First, let's try to plug in a value into a function. And if we actually get something back, then this f of c actually exists. In step 1, we have this equation. F of x is equal to 5x squared minus 6x plus 1. And the value of our x will be 2. Let's make it more easier. F of 2 is equal to 5 quantity of 2 squared minus 6 times 2 plus 1. The final answer will be f of 2 is equal to 9. In step 2, limit of f of x as x approaches to c exists. We should also check if the limit exists as x approaches to c value. We have still the same equation, but there's a limit on it. So, the limit of 5x squared minus 6x plus 1 as x approaches to c, and the value of x will be the same, 2. Let's make it more easier. The limit of 5x squared minus 6x plus 1 will be 5 quantity of 2 squared minus 6 times 2 plus 1. And the final answer will be 9. In step 3, limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to f of c. Finally, if you get these two things that are at least exist, and you want to make sure that the both of them get the same value, therefore, we can say that the function is continuous at that point. In our given equation, the both equation has the same value, which is 9. So we can say that this both equation is continuous in that certain point. That's all for this day. I hope you learned something in this video clip. For more inquiries and questions, just visit our FB page, Matematika de Cubalan. And for our website, just visit www.edu.cubalan.edu.ph. And for our math quote for this day, life is a math equation. In order to gain the most, you have to know how to convert negative into positive. That's all, and goodbye.